In this example, we're going to calculate the freezing point depression of water. We add 304.7 grams of glucose to a liter of water. And what we're going to use is an approximate equation. This is the mole fraction of water in the mixture, the ideal gas constant, the freezing point of pure water. That's, of course, the same value that's here. This is the freezing point of the mixture. This is what we're trying to determine. And this is the enthalpy change fusion. And this makes some assumptions. The big one is ideal solution. In a separate screencast, we go through more details of where this equation came from. In order to do this calculation, going to need to calculate the mole fraction of water. So what we'll do is calculate the mole fraction of the solute. So we need to determine the number of moles of the solute. We have 304.7 grams of the glucose. Determine its molecular weight, 180.2 grams per mole. So this corresponds to 1.691 moles of glucose. We have 1,000 grams of water in a liter, and it's 18 grams per mole, so this is 55 moles of water. So the mole fraction of our solute, 1.691 moles of glucose over the total number of moles, which is the water plus the glucose, and this gives us a mole fraction of 0.0295, which means the mole fraction of water is just 1 minus this. So the mole fraction of water that we'll substitute in the equation, 0.9705. So I reproduced the equation here, and then I rewrote it in order to solve for what we're interested in, which is the change in the freezing temperature. So now we're going to substitute in the values into this equation. And so I put in the gas constant in units that are consistent with the heat of fusion value. The freezing point of pure water, 0 degrees centigrade, 273 Kelvin, has to be absolute temperature. And then the log of the mole fraction of water, the units cancel, so the right side has units of Kelvin. And if we then calculate this number, minus 3.09 Kelvin. So the temperature change, it would mean the temperature where the mixture freezes is 269.9 Kelvin, or minus 3.1 essentially centigrade. Dropped the freezing point by that small amount. There's alternate ways that you'll see this freezing point depression equation written. So I reproduce the equation here. Now we can write this as 1 minus the mole fraction of the solute. Now it turns out when x is small, this left side of the equation essentially minus x of the solute, just a mathematical relation. And so this is often the format where, of course, delta T is just T for the solution minus T of the pure material. And if we use this equation, we get almost the same temperature change. We get minus 3.04 decrease in temperature. The other thing to keep in mind is if we were to add a salt that dissociates, then we have to account for that in the mole fraction, because if we had, for example, potassium chloride and we add it 1.691 moles, then we have to account for the fact that we're essentially adding twice as many moles. So we are adding really 3.382 moles of ions, potassium ions and chloride ions, and we have to then use that number in the calculation.